I want to say, if you're getting this message, you've become perhaps very ungraspable for people. And in many ways, some people might be worried that you've taken on a route that's not something that they can join you in. You've delved deep into something that they can't really fetch you out of this time. In many ways, the people that may not have been privy to your pain, the people that may not have cared about you, are inclined to show up at this time. They feel driven to show you that they support you. They have gratitude for what you've done for them. They care. They want to be present in your life. Whatever it is that they did not do in the past, these energies are doing it now. I don't know what to call it, because a lot of you have stepped into your calling, whatever that might be. You've stepped into the unknown. And whether you even acknowledge it or not, you don't care about certain things anymore. And in that, you have opened up a reservoir of so many different energies. I keep coming back to this, especially in June, because there is an integration happening that's so pivotal. Something that has escaped the grasp of those of you out there who've been so sensitive and so in tune with people, yet received in return something so scarce that made you so insecure to the point where you may have even ventured to better yourself, to make yourself available at any cost. But somewhere down the road, for better or for worse, but I'm feeling like it's for better, you gave up. You gave up in attempting to reach people at any cost. And in that case, if you're relating with this message so far, a lot of stories are being rewritten about you. A lot of stories are being written about you freshly. And people almost want to come into your preview. They want to come into your life. New, old, in the middle. And this could be, in many ways, bringing up certain emotions for you. Like that of, for some, where were you then? Why now? I want to say one thing here. For so long, perhaps you were the energy that wanted to be included, that didn't quite understand why people stood against you, even though you had good intentions. And eventually you gave up on that, perhaps. You went internally and started to love yourself, appreciate yourself. Through that process, you have several energies now that wish to include themselves in your life. A lot of you feel very angsty about this, if I'm not lying. Almost upset. Like the dead are being risen, and this is a skeleton that you don't want to deal with. Like you've buried this. But in many ways, these energies They're there to confirm a part of you that has always been there. A part of you that they've always, in some way, resented or pushed away. Because it made them feel naked. It made them feel seen. And real. Whether you believe it or not, a lot of people are okay with living in a fantasy. Even though the projection or the verdict is that you're living in the fantasy, that you're not really seeing reality correctly. If you've been in my channel this long, you know how we talk about reality. But the truth is, reality does not exist in that linear sense. And in many ways, those who are aware of it, those who live by the laws naturally that exist within them, are bound to be considered insane. So, in this isolation, people have developed some type of superiority complex towards you. And in many ways, they had a hidden reservoir, an intuition about you that you were anything but ignorant. This is the element, my left ear is ringing, that's coming up at this time. So, as you are flapping your wings away, so to speak, busy, a lot of you could be invested in yourself to the point where you're not really bothered about the past. And it's noise to you. Well, here is the noise. They're coming. Because you've unlocked something, not just within you, but within the collective. You've released something. And this is what vampirism is. There's almost a calling, an urge for them to do the same. But a lot of people won't see it that way. They project. So they're coming onto you heavy, perhaps, at this point. Lovers, friends, family, relatives, doesn't matter, really. In fact, some people will go as far as questioning your intentions, questioning who you are. Coming at you from an angle that's very odd, accusatory, to say the least. Because they want to get something on you. They want to slow you down in some way. I mentioned this before. There is a speeding up process, right? A bubble process happening for some of you where you're absorbing so much of the collective pain and transmuting it at such a fast pace where your growth is exponential at this point. And the things of this world may not matter to you in the gravity in the sense that they did at one point. So your relation with people, with lovers, with the past has changed in such a positive way. So in order for these people to meet you, they're having to face a past version of themselves. They're having to act in the authentic way that they wanted to act with you in the past, but they withheld. Because they were either insecure, they had so much ego or pride. So now they're playing out a past version of themselves towards you. Whether that be in the fashion of like them giving you a compliment that they never did. Being grateful towards you. Asking you how you were if they never did. Being a person, period, towards you. That they never were, that they purposefully withheld in the past because they thought you were the underdog, that you were never going to rise in the extent that they believed the timeline would allow you, because we were living in a time of density in the past. We're not doing that anymore. The veil is lifted. So the truth, it doesn't need to be defended. It's there for all to see. So the shadows about you that have been cast, that have been successful in the past, aren't anymore. So these people from the past, people in the present, are finally treating you, or going to, in the way that they intended to. You know? Whether positive or negative, that doesn't really matter. The truth is coming out. There is a freedom in the air. People don't have reservations anymore about who they really are, what they really want to do, what they really want to say. There's an open door, and we're walking through it. What is through your door? I love asking you questions. What is through your door? What do you see? What do you see? Sorry for yelling. My AC came on and I just started to like yell. With that being said, I'll just leave this video here. It's kind of like a casual video today. So my ladies, with that being said, until next time, bye.